Welcome back. I guess it's, I guess you could say it's done. It turned out pretty good. As you can see, it's stain took and cleaned up quite nice. Yeah, I thought we'd have a couple of tweaks in that I'd have to do to it. I haven't actually set up the pot yet. I'm in no hurry to do that. I'm basically using it as a buffer right now, which actually sounds pretty damn good. I mean, it's going direct to the amp. None of this works on the front. It's just basically a block amp. This is all dead in the front, except for the display. And there's no volume control on that amp. It's just a straight amp block that plugs into there. If there was any issues with it, there'd be a humming. You'd be able to pick it up. It's dead quiet. The only thing it does do is when you first turn it on, which I will show you, there'll be a like white noise or a hiss that goes from the left to the right speaker, and then it fades out. I guess it's a two-plate steps up. I might try changing the value of the two caps. Probably doesn't like that. Or it could be the tubes itself. These tubes have had a long service life, and they were originally in a Philips micro system or mini system, and there was no vents. Basically, these are housed in an aluminum case in the front with a glass window. And so they've probably been in the heat for a couple of years, and they do generate a lot of heat because these are actually not your 12 volt tubes that they got running on these little systems. These are the plate voltage on these are, I think it's 180. So they do get quite warm. If you touch the tube and you turn it on, your fingerprints will burn off of the tube. So these have been pretty hot. So what I'm going to try and do is they are the 12 AX7s. And I want to try the ECC 83s or something like that. Anything equivalent to it. Any pair, I guess. I got them from the tube store in Hamilton. Anyway, let me turn everything on and let you hear what it sounds like when you first turn it on. Yep. You should be able to pick it up. There it goes. Give it a minute. And there it is. And then it disappears. And then it's fine once it warms up, which it is. You can see that they've, I can tell when the tube's seen a lot of heat over the years because it gets glary on the inside of the tube. It looks like it's dirty on the outside, but it's not. That's the inside. So they've definitely seen some heat. It's all right, though. They're good for testing. And like I said, it turned out. Let me show you the back. Unplug it. Pretty straightforward. Like I said, I'll replace this plug eventually with something with a fuse. Yeah, the feeder on. It's all good. It just kind of worked out that I had stain that was pretty much the same color as the stain that was on it, so I could do the lip. But that looks pretty damn nice for a cabinet. I'm just leaving this open. I'm not going to bother bolting it down or anything. It's not like it's going to be rolling around anytime soon. That just sucks that it cracked there. Oh, what are you going to do? Anyway, it is done. I figured I would just get this out of the way and make a quick video showing the finished product. I ended up doing a couple of things with stain. That's my Bluetooth receiver. I did my needle holder. And this is probably the coolest one right here. This stuff is still curing. This is the Fozzy Audio. And that looks pretty cool. Jesus Christ. And he drops it. Does look cool though, eh? Yeah. Looks really nice. I'm looking forward to seeing what the other one I got wood for these too. I want to see what one of them looks like when it's stained. Look at that. It's nice when you see through it. It's cool. We'll see what those look like. Next project will be the turntable. I've been putting it off. I've decided to go with the RCA mod only because you can direct the LED light to hit the needle. We'll probably put it right here. And I also like it, you can loosen it off, pull it off the RCA and leave the RCA here. It won't be in the way. Beats the other idea. Plus I have other things I gotta do. I gotta fix this, it's loose. And do the wiring on the back. Still got quite a bit of hum. But I'll get to this as soon as I can. I'll make it a separate video. Anyway, take it easy, guys.